upon those insecurities and all, the graphotherapy process is designed. Say a person may have very few fears or maybe just hardly insecurities. That can be overcome, say, within a month span or within a 15-day span. But at times, especially when it comes to students, they have a lot of fears, insecurities and all. So depending upon the complexity, it may take 1.5 to 2 months also. Okay? And this also goes hand in hand with the counseling process. Okay. Now, overall, handwriting analysis and the graphology helps us not only to understand a student and helps a student to earn a better rank and recognition. It helps in the vocational guidance. It helps the parents to understand where exactly the child is standing, where exactly these problems are, the concern areas. It helps the HRD people to keep the right people into the profession. It helps an individual not only to help his own self to understand but also others. It helps the psychologist to gain an insight into the patient's problem through the specific fears what I have told you all. It helps the lawyers to understand the sincerity of the clients. The businessman can achieve more profits by keeping the right person, by using the handwriting analysis process. It can also be helpful in the marriage guidance, because today no two people are same. It's mostly common that the people project something as of socializing and everything, but when it comes to handwriting, it helps us to understand a person much more clear. Now, mind scans helps not only in the graphotherapy process, but also I do help in the career counseling, the handwriting improvement, the signature designing, and logo designing. Logo designing, I mean to say, designing the cards, pamphlets, brochures and all that, where actually handwriting works. The process of handwriting is there. Now, even just off lately, I have also come up with different courses in handwriting as of the basic and the advanced course. Basic course is something which is compulsory in my subject, because it helps us to understand the introduction, the history and the background of graphology, the handwriting analysis. It helps us to understand the emotional response, as I said earlier, the whether a person is an introvert, extrovert and all. It helps us to understand the emotional depth in the pressure, that is how much impact of a thing will last within a person. The different types of thinking process, how to recognize and how to identify whether a person is slow learner or a fast learner. It helps us to understand in this course the different imagination ability, that is the abstract and the material imagination. And it also helps us to understand a couple of extra traits, that is specific alphabets which are beneficial to understand and to know about a person. Okay. The second thing in the course is the advance. Once the person clears with the basic course, he can actually offer 3 different advanced courses. Okay, where the first course is the teachers and the students course. Now, in this course, I'll be dealing upon handwriting improvement, how to actually take up with the handwriting improvement, not only with the English handwriting, but also with the Hindi and the Marathi, how to improve upon it. Now, as you all know, that anything, whatever we touch in a handwriting, is actually a therapy process. Now, something might be wrong, because of which the handwriting actually got spoiled, or I can say it became illegible or something. So in the second part, the B factor, we actually help the person to not only understand why exactly the handwriting analysis is done, what all things has to be remembered as of the handwriting improvement, and the rectification in this part, we actually say what was before the handwriting improvement and what will be after impact of the handwriting improvement. The goals, willpower and the determination, the improvement of the concentration and the memory is dealt in this specific course. The third course is the counselor's course, where I'll be dealing with the different types of behavior. As of, for example, maybe a person is quite slow, maybe a person is very irritated, okay, a person is very slobby, very moody kind. So there are many different types of behavior which a person faces from person to person. It differs. So those all things which can be identified through handwriting is dealt in the detecting behavior. The anger management, there are different types of anger in a person, nothing as of a specific. And there are different types of fears, what I have earlier shown to you all. And neutral therapy, how to actually overcome those fears, those insecurities, can be dealt in the neutral therapy. Now the fourth is the professional course, which is actually designed for the lawyers as well as the doctors, the forensic level, where I'll be dealing with the different stress factor. See, in this project there are 20 different traits through which we can identify the stress level we actually face upon. Because today everybody are more prone to stress and we don't take care of ourselves. So when it comes to handwriting, it becomes so fast and so quick that if we just match our handwriting and just check with those 20 traits what is there in the stress chapter. If suppose the handwriting matches 3 to 4, which is just common with everybody. Everybody has some or the other ups and downs. But when it comes to, say, matching 5, at least 5 traits are matching, means the person actually has some problem and really needs to go for urgent counseling. The second thing is the social traits. The different types of socializing traits are dealt in this project. The different types of honesty and the dishonesty traits are dealt in the integrity traits project. The different types of depression and the suicidal tendencies. Today, suicides and all is most common. Something happens and it's like more of in a fashion. Okay, so this project is something which will help us to understand the depression tendencies. How much a person is into depression, how much a person is into problem. And this process is a very fast process where just on the basis of handwriting analysis, we can check upon whether a person is really bound to commit anything as of a suicide or may do something as of a serious action. Okay, which goes much more faster. Now, let me help you all in the last to analyze your own handwriting. Okay, please just check upon with your own handwriting. I'll be just showing you a couple of alphabets and you can identify your own personality looking at your own handwriting. Okay, now let's check upon your handwriting. Just see alphabet D. Whether the handwriting shows an alphabet D, which is towards the left, that is just a plain stem above, or it is a loop one, the left or the right. The left with a plain stem D shows a trait called as dignity. Now this person is the one who won't bend so easily, who won't give up things so easily, will be able to stand on his own feet and is a very adamant and strong person. The one who makes an alphabet D with a loop is the one who is very sensitive. Okay? Now, they take things to heart. They find it difficult to interact with others so easily. And anything as of comes in their process, as of a hindrance or I can say anything as of a criticism, it stops their progress. And they actually ponder their own problems, they ponder their own weaknesses, and it disturbs them a lot. Just check with the alphabet E what you all have made in your handwriting, whether it is the left open kind of an E or is a closed kind of an E. It looks like a C actually. Okay. The one who makes the left one, that is the open E, are the ones who are very open to listening. Okay. They are good counselors, they are very helpful, and they are almost very obedient, I can see. Okay. And the one who makes the narrow or the pinched alphabet E are the ones who are not so good when it comes to listening. It's like something has happened or something as of criticism or something as disturbing, cause of which for temporary maybe they have just shut their ears. They just don't want to listen. You may find especially this kind of traits when it comes to the handwriting of your students. As you all can see, there are two different types of I. On the left you can see the dot is just exact a dot above the stem. And on the right, instead of dot, there is a circle, heart, or specific kind of structures what actually we make. Now, the one who makes left type of I dot, the left side, the specific I dot above the stem, are the people who have good mind. They are very good when it comes to memory. They are very good when it comes to attention. They are very loyal and obedient kind of a person. Whereas the one who makes circle or heart or anything as of instead of dot are the ones who are very creative. They are more into their imagination and their presence of mind is not so nice because of their creativeness. Now, let's check upon the last alphabet, say alphabet F. As you can see on the top, the loops of up loop and the down loop of F are proper, and the second one is the one, it looks like a G, but many people actually make F like this. Now the top one are the people who are very good when it comes to planning, organization. They are very systematic and appropriate in their dealings. Okay, very much like, you know, I can say a timetable kind, or maybe a very routine oriented, properly systematic. Whereas the one who makes the down kind of an F, where only upper loop is visible, or maybe the upper loop is not there, only the down loop is there. Okay, these are the people who are not so systematic when it comes to working, when it comes to action. At times they plan but they don't work, and at times they are so much into the work that they don't plan. So they are quite unsystematic when it comes to the planning aspect. Okay. Now with this, actually I end my today's lecture. But I'm open to question answers. Anybody has any question answers regarding the subject? Has anybody? Yeah, please.
Basically, I'm a lawyer by vocation.
Okay.
And I myself undertake work of disorder checks, wherein the accused who is given a check which gets dishonored takes this defense, I'll not put the signature, in which case the handwriting expert comes in the picture.
Okay.
The expert evidence is provided in Indian Evidence Act. I would like to know, first of all, the history of graphology and graphotherapy. Are they synonyms or they are different? Graphology and graphotherapy.
See, graphology is the handwriting analysis. The technical name of handwriting is graphology. And it helps us to understand the details of the subject. Whereas the therapy is totally different to graphology. Therapy is something what we are putting into process.
So there is no correlation or anything?
No, it is related. As of the graphology is something which we understand as of looking at the handwriting to understand the personality. And graphotherapy is something we give as of practices to overcome those negative traits and all.
No, because it is so confusing that I had attended one workshop like this on
okay.
graphology. And it seems on the basis of the signature, certain predictions were made by the speaker.
Okay.
So as now, as you said, that there can be no astrological connotation. It's surely the
no.
personality traits can be deciphered.
Yes.
So is the person who, if you say there is correlation, then how can this is very scientific as far as the, you know, you said if you put pressure, you are impactful.
Yes.
Graphology mere on the basis of mere signature. Like for instance, the boss the other day he said, yes, are you ambitious? I said yes, and I signed like this. He said you're not ambitious because there's a slight curve which is going below, put it up and you'll become ambitious. Is that possible?
See, when it comes to signature helps us to understand only 10% of the entire personality, whereas the entire 95% is there. So almost 80 to 85% can be revealed only through the handwriting. Signature is just 5 to 10%. And signature is something which helps us to understand the outer image, the public image of a person. The person may be something different but wants to project something different as of through signature. Okay, and signature is not used everywhere. It is just used specifically on checks or some documents or something. Okay, so many people actually tend to decorate their signature. They make it more complicated so that, you know, nobody actually copies it and all that. But they don't know the impact of what exactly they do by making certain things as of, you know, decorating their signature. Okay, by making it complicated and all that. They don't know the impact. At times we do find that the handwriting is much more clear, legible. Okay, but when it comes to signature, it is illegible, which means that the person doesn't want anybody else to know him as of out, but he is much more clear person when it comes to the personal ground, and the vice versa.
I have one last question.
Yes.
As you said that in certain manner in which we write, it, you know, indicates or it is evident that you have certain personality trait. But in case one gets conversant with graphotherapy and tries to change it, how long does it take to change or because once you write, it's very natural when you write.
Right.
You don't
have
to compare yourself. But
right.
after getting conversant with graphotherapy, someone makes an effort to change, a drastic effort to convert himself into a dramatically different personality. It can happen, or there
See.
Can be only changes to the extent one wants to... One is desirous of those changes.
See, when it comes to handwriting and when it comes to a person, nobody is perfect. Okay? Everybody has some of the other negative qualities. many of the positive qualities depending from person to person. And as it was shown in the very basic thing that no two people have the same handwriting, because no two people have the same fingerprint, no two people have the same DNA, no two people have the same iris. The same thing goes with handwriting. Okay, now handwriting helps us to understand many a different factors, as I showed you, the emotions, the depth, the different types of imagination aspect, the different types of fears and all that. And depending upon the complexity what you are saying, okay, suppose we come across a specific problem, usually which I come across the counseling the students. When I come across a student, like maybe the handwriting shows stubbornness or less of memory or poor concentration and all that. That all can be worked upon, because first and foremost, handwriting helps us to not only identify those negative traits or the insecurities of the child or the adult through handwriting, but it is much more clear to the person itself, okay, they are into this category. They are having this problem. It's not that in everybody is just shouting them that, okay, you are absent-minded. It's their problem. And we tend to find out why exactly and what exactly has landed into these insecurities through the many different aspects of the handwriting. It's just one thing which we come to know. No, there are many things with handwriting which we come to know. 95% on all grounds. Okay, it helps us to understand the mental, physical and the emotional aspect of the person. So anything as of insecurity, first it has been identified on the basis of handwriting, and then that is dealt not only through the counseling but also through the graphotherapy. And graphotherapy works because, as I said, handwriting analysis or handwriting is something as of brain handwriting. So the brain gives instructions to muscles and our muscles give instructions to our hand and we write. So what we do is we make certain changes in our handwriting and give a reverse direction to the brain. Okay, and as you all have seen that every time we write, a neural pathway is generated. Okay, so whenever we change our handwriting, we are actually altering the process of the neural pathway, and that is where it works. And after some time, because it doesn't work or it doesn't happen overnight. As I said, that depending upon the complexity of the problem a person is facing upon, it may take 15 days also, it may take 2 months also. Okay, so it takes time. And as I can say that the handwriting improvement, say the simplest thing what I can make you all understand is the handwriting improvement. Handwriting improvement is something like, first and foremost, why handwriting becomes illegible, why handwriting is distorted, we can't understand. Because a person is complex, the personality of the person is complex. Many a times, like, you know, we being a practical person, but at times some of the other disturbances or some of the other problems arises and we don't know where to go, what to do. So even though we are practical minded, we tend to become emotional. We tend to take certain emotional actions. Okay? So this is something like through handwriting, what only we come to know of the person, but the insecurities and everything is been dealt upon counseling. Okay? Especially when I work with students, I help the parents to understand their qualities so that, you know, they can take the best of the guidance, the best of the effort to actually keep up to the child's ambition.